Callum day off. Callum day off making his way to the ring. Penultimate contest, Diaf and Dan Naylor. 6 3-minute rounds, the lightweight division. One more fight and then we've got Jack Massey. One whack. All the fights have gone the distance so far. '55, that last fight there with Maxi Hughes. Ryan Walsh has tweeted in again. Looks like his missus has let him put the iPad on. He's known these two lads since the amateurs. He's looking forward to it. May the best man win. Dan Naylor in the black trunks. Callum Diaf in the white trunks with red trim. If Naylor's up for this, we could have a good fight on our hands. Here we go, first round. Diaf looking to be aggressive. He's got centre of the ring already. Naylor quite methodical. Takes shots on his gloves well, Naylor. Diaf looking to be the aggressor in there. Apply pressure to Naylor. Naylor's keeping a nice tight guard. Nice left hand there from Diaf. He's crazy the way he works his way around to the right hand, but he did land a good right hand to the body, Diaf. Naylor's falling short of that jab. He's tried throwing it two or three times. Diaf has kind of got centre of the ring. Naylor's trying to work his way off the ropes. Naylor didn't like that, telling off from the ref, give it him back. Getting himself a yellow card, son. Diaf comes in from all kind of angles when he gets light on his feet and kind of goes to his right to land a straight jab. Usual style. I've seen Callum box a few times. Good kid, 7 wins, just the 1 defeat. 1 defeat coming into our hands at Luke Wilton. Every record I've looked at tonight feels like it's got Kazim Hussein's name on. Get the tweets coming in, guys. Hashtag VIP Boxing Live. Looking forward to catching Jack Massey. Tomasi's boxed on the on Matchroom shows, boxed on the Scott Quigg bills, Anthony Crawler bills in Manchester for Eddie Earn, Matchroom. Tonight, it's headlining the Devonshire Dome. Absolutely magnificent venue. Getting it out for all the posh totty ringside. Three course meal with a fruit salad. Then we've got the rest of the folk, where I'd be stood at the bar, 35 quid having a beer. That's how you should spend your Friday nights. Get down to the boxing, or get it on VIP Boxing TV. Spend your Friday nights with a claymaker. People tweeting in now about Jack Massey, they're looking forward to the fight. Nearly 750 tickets he sold tonight. And DFA coming back to his corner. First round, another sixth round of this fight. Myself a little table, so not round it was. Dia for Naylor, first round. Second round coming up. And one more fight to go. Top of the bill, Jack Massey, Gunga Lassa. Laban refereeing again. All four of the undercard fights. Yeah, let's just sit on the ropes. Def seems a little tentative to let his shots go. I'll be wary of the left hand from Naylor coming back. Just pot shot in a little bit there, Diaf. Pushing down, I think the referee will have a little word with Diaf there. Not a lot behind these shots, just placing him. It's given an opportunity, he lands the shot. Not a lot offensively from Naylor. Nice left hand to the body there from Diaf. Four or five shots to the back, to the head. Nice jab landed there, and a follow-up left hand as well. A little bit more success coming here from Diaf. I'd like to see him turn that left hand over, turn it into a hook. Taylor there just looks like a meerkat popping his head out of the tunnel. Grinning at each other in there. Five rounds of professional boxing in Buxton. Five fights. Throwing the jab again there, Naylor. Did a nice job to the body. Nice right hand again there from Naylor. So a little bit more encouragement. Diaf responds with a left hand. Naylor waving him in. Nice right hand to the body. That registered with Naylor. With a couple of right hands as well. Ron Naylor's lost 19 times, but he's only been stopped twice. Andy Colquhoun took him out in the fourth round of a four-rounder. He's at the Echo Arena. Hamid Gaz, he took him out in the first round. Again, that was on a Josh Warrington bill. Oh, worry. Josh Warrington looking to get out again before Christmas. There's rumours he's going to be on one of the Germany shows. Martin Murray and his Barmy army going out to Hanover to tackle Arthur King Abraham on the 21st. And a week later in Dusseldorf, the big men are getting it on. Tyson Fury tackling Vladimir Klitschko. How's everybody seeing those two fights? We've talked about Quigg and Frampton. We've talked about Andy Lee and Billy Joe Saunders. I think Klitschko's going to knock Tyson Fury out. I'd love to see Tyson Fury do it. I think it'd be great for British boxing. I just cannot see it. And Martin Murray, I'm tipping Martin to bring the belt home. Bring it back to the UK, to the Northwest, to St. Helens. We don't have a lot to celebrate after last season, the people of St. Helens. Third round, I've given both rounds to Diaf. Might see Naylor do a little bit more on the offensive. Seems to be repeating myself. Nice right hand to the body there from Naylor. Naylor again there. Diaf just rushing in a little bit. Better from Naylor. Labayim stepping forward and showing more encouragement, also giving more encouragement there to Diaf. Good to see, good action. This fight's threatening to really kick off. It's not done yet. It's a little bit like when you don't start your barbecue at the right time. Need to a little bit more lighter fluid in there. It's enough to cook sausages, but you're not going to cook a steak. Right hand's working well for Naylor. He's got his eyes fixed on Naylor in there. He's waiting for the opportunities. He's waiting for the hands to drop. A couple of tweets in referring to the fights I've just been mentioning in Germany. Apparently I'd have more chance of beating Klitschko than Fury, according to Martin Smith. You won't be saying that if you're seeing me out in Tenerife, Martin. You can ask Ryan Walsh about that. Ryan thinks Martin's going to need a KO in Germany. Been there before with Sturm. Thinks Arthur's solid. One of my friends has wrote a cracking piece this week. I'm going to try and get it onto the internet, get it on Twitter and Facebook, about Martin Murray, about the judges, about my experiences I've had with his opponents. Sergio Martinez, Maravilla, Felix Sturm out in Germany. And then the judges weren't needed when he boxed Gennady Golovkin this February in Monte Carlo. I was there and it was a privilege to see GGG. My opinion now is probably the pound for pound best boxer on the planet. Superstar now, Golovkin. I think he's going to box in front of full houses every time he fights. But as much as I enjoyed going to Madison Square Garden and watching Cotto and Martinez, I really don't think you can beat watching a small all show as well. These lads working their way up. Nice right hand there from Naylor. These lads here tonight were looking to get the record to 10-0, to get Eddie Hearn to pick the phone up. Frank Warren say, come and box on one of my shows. Get the opportunities to box for titles. Great to see. Jack Massey, he's been there, he's boxed on the Eddie Hearn shows. He's experienced it, he wants a bit more of it. Callum Diaf, he's going to want a little bit of that. Charlie Schofield, 3-0, he's going to want a little bit of it. Jake Bulger, 3-0. Maxi Hughes, he boxed at the York Hall, headlined a Sky Bill. Then he took on Martin Ward in chief support, he's going to want that again. Just been talking about Ryan Walsh. Ryan Walsh was one of the co-headliners on a world title bill at Wembley Arena. All these people that are sitting ringside, you get on board with one of your friends, if you get on board with somebody you know through work, it's great to follow the journey all the way. Terry Flanagan recently won a world title. You could see how much it meant to him, but you could see how much he went back to his local boozer after the fight. It means so much to these lads. It means so much to the team, to the fans, to the friends. The greatest sport of all is boxing. Back here into the fourth round now. Callum Diaf, Dan Naylor. Past the halfway point now, we're into the fourth, three to go. Diaf's just shown a little bit classier work for me. Naylor's had glimpses, he's thrown a couple of nice right hands to the body. So he's a little bit cautious letting his backhand go. He goes, steps in with a couple of jabs and then it's just that left hand. And the backhand go. Diaf's got nice and tidy. Shaking it out there, nice and relaxed. I think he's enjoying himself in there. Attempted to land the right uppercut. Not too sure what's going on there. Doing rabbit impressions with the gloves. This crowd now, they're just getting on tender hooks now, ready for Jack Massey. The main event is coming up next. WBC silver youth title in the cruiserweight division. He's fighting a triple G, but it's not that one. Gogita Gogakarte. Looking to ruin the night for Jack Massey. He said a lot of these people are sitting around me. There we go, there we go. Little bit cocky there from Naylor. Callum Diaf didn't like it. Hit him with a volley of body shots. Naylor lands a nice left hand there, coming off the ropes himself. Diaf gets back to his boxing. Nice right hand there. Naylor puts the earmuffs on again. Nice left hand there from Naylor. I think Diaf's winning the rounds. Naylor's giving him problems in nearly all of the rounds. It's making him think about it. Some of the stuff them two are doing in there. It's like watching two kids in a nightclub flirting with each other. Who's going to ask who for the dance? Balls to that, just get it on. Naylor again. Looked to land the 1-2. Little step back from Diaf, landed a nice left hook similar to that, but then moved to the other side and looked to land the right. Little head clash there. Just looking for a bit, looking for a sign of claret. I can't see any. End of the round. Well, nobody told me they've changed it from a 6 to a 4. I've got that a shutout, 40-36. Apologies about that, that fight got changed there. Down as a 6th rounder, it's only a 4 rounder. Didn't hear John Peck talking about something earlier on. Not too sure what happened there. Keep the tweets coming in, guys. Hashtag VIP Boxing Live. Not too sure there. We'll try and find out. VIP Boxing Live. Versus Maxi Hughes, British title eliminator. What a great 50-50 fight. Great shout, Mark. Let's get that fight made. 13th round of tweeted in. But Diaf was getting a little fatigued. He was slower to get out of the pocket. Chin a little bit more exposed. He was good with his angles.